Do we have to put arc fault breakers in panels if we're just replacing the panel? All right, I had a really good question asked in the comments from Cali Electro Dad from the Outlawed Panels and Breakers video. It says, can you please point out a code section that requires upgrading to AFCI breakers when changing a panel? My understanding of the exception to 210.12D is that if the branch circuit wire from the final overcurrent to outlet is not changed and no new devices are added, then no AFCI is required. He's right. So let's break open code. 210.12D. So 210.12D is for branch circuit extensions or modifications, dwelling units, dorm units, and guest rooms and guest suites, where branch circuit wiring of any of these areas specified in 210.12A, B, or C is modified, replaced, or extended. The branch circuit shall be protected by one of the following: by any of the means described in 210.12A1 through A6, or a listed outlet branch circuit type AFCI located at the first receptacle outlet of the existing branch circuit. So that is saying, if branch circuit wiring is modified, replaced, or extended, then you do have to protect with an arc fault breaker or arc fault receptacle or one of these methods of arc faulting. But there's an exception underneath that that says, exception, AFCI protection shall not be required where the extension of the existing branch circuit conductors is not more than 6 feet. So if you're changing out like a foot of conductor, technically you don't have to do it. And does not include any additional outlets or devices other than splicing devices. This measurement shall not include the conductors inside an enclosure, cabinet, or junction box. So essentially right there, if you're changing out some wiring or if you're changing out a breaker and you're not extending the circuit or anything, technically no, you don't have to change out to arc fault breakers. But I will say that it depends on the authority having jurisdiction in your area. Is an inspector gonna come? Or is, you know, like, even if a house is being sold later on and you have an inspector come and look at the situation and be like, oh, we're not going to pass that because we want you to put arc fault protection in. It's always down to the local authority that has jurisdiction over these things. And in my area, we have a whole bunch of different cities, but amongst them, there are cities that they do not care. If you're doing anything in a house, you have to go change every single one of the receptacles to a tamper-resistant receptacle. If you've touched anything inside the house or at the service, if you've touched the service and you've pulled breakers out or you've pulled a panel out, put a new panel, they don't care. They're not gonna pass your inspection unless you put those arc fault breakers in. So it's just a matter of knowing, right? Like this thing, I say this time and time again, this is a minimum standard. This is a guide that governments and areas of jurisdiction use to create their own standards with. This is the bare kind of minimum. And this isn't the only one. This is just the biggest group that make this, the NFPA. There's other codes out there that other areas adhere to. So this just kind of gives the authority and gives those in authority a basis to say, here's what we think is like a good way of doing this kind of work. And they will usually take it and they'll be like, why do people do that? Why? Lick your fingers and then stick it in a book and flip pages? Like, have you ever had a book and you just hand it to somebody and they start reading and they're like, oh, thanks for letting me look through your book. And then they just give the thing back. It's the most disgusting thing. Stop licking your fucking fingers and putting them in pages. Dude, it's gross. Anyways, this is something that a lot of times they will go and look through and they'll figure out, well, we don't really like this and we're not gonna worry about this. And in fact, this is 2020. We're just gonna stick with the 2008 because that's the one that we like. So it's not universal. Code is never universal. It's just that this is kind of a universally agreed upon by the majority standard. And it's the minimum standard. You can always go above and beyond it. But even what's in here may not be how you have to do it out wherever you live in Podunk, whoeverville. You always have to check with your authority having jurisdiction. So they're really the ones that are going to have the say about it. But my dude, that was a very good comment. Something I didn't mention. Yes, you don't have to, if you're authority having jurisdiction actually uses this standard, you do not have to do that. Now, if you're curious about arc fault protection in general, I have a video right here. This is AFCI, GFCI, dual function breakers. Kind of explains what each one's for. And if you want to watch stuff about how breakers actually work, this is a really good video too. Love you crazy people, and I'll see you in the next one.